Hi there, Lindsay here. Welcome back to my channel, Inside the Hem. Even though you wouldn't know it by the crazy hot temperatures here in South Carolina, it's officially fall. And that means it's time for Stylemaker Fabric's Fall Style Tour. It's easily one of my favorite collaborations since Michelle lets us pick whatever fabrics we like and make whatever we want. This year, I wanted something that screamed fall, but I also wanted something on trend. And when I saw the stretch camo, I knew I was onto something. Camo has taken the world by storm here in the past few months. It's absolutely everywhere. Since the Stylemaker Fabrics camo is intended for bottom weight, and y'all know how I hate making pants, I opted for a basic denim skirt pattern. After looking at several options, I landed on Style Arc's Sally jean skirt. Fair warning, this is not for beginners. The instructions are vague and the few illustrations that are included are more confusing than they are helpful. I was able to get a good fit by doing a half inch full seat adjustment similar to the tutorial I posted with Abby a couple of years ago. I also ended up tapering the side seams to give it less of an A-line and more of a pencil shape. If you need some camo in your life too, the textured camo stretch bottom weight I used was great. It's very sturdy, but still has some give to it, which is nice for a skirt, pants, or shorts. It also has enough weight to it that it would make a great utility jacket, too. Stylemaker Fabrics is offering two additional camos this season. One is this gorgeous tonal gray, which is a little more subtle, and the classic sateen, both of which would make great dresses, why not, skirts, like pencil, A-line, circle, or pleated, pants, shorts, or even a cute jacket. The top really was fate. I saw a couple of these lace-up back sweaters on Pinterest, and I knew I could make one if I was able to find the right fabrics. When I saw Stylemaker Fabrics had sweater knit with matching rib knit, I knew it was time to make this sweater a reality. I used a standard V-neck sweater pattern, McCall's 7660 to be exact, filled in the front neckline, dropped the back neckline to a V at the waistline, lengthened and narrowed the binding, and added eyelets. I opted for self fabric for the ties, which I think gives it a cozier vibe. If you want to make your own lightweight sweater this year, this sweater knit and matching rib are a dream to work with. Michelle has them in four colors, magenta, ruby, and jade. Purple is available as a sweater knit, but not in the rib. I hope y'all like my new outfit. If you want a tutorial on the sweater, let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, check the description box for links to the fabrics mentioned in this video. I'll also have links to the previous stops on the tour. We are close to the end, and there have been so many exceptional makes by them women and men that have come before me. I hope you'll give them some love too. But until next time, I'll see you all very soon. Bye!